Before we start, I want to tell you guys about blackpenredpen. It is a wonderful place for you guys to go if you are interested to learn about how to solve interesting and challenging math questions. And I often go there to grab information or maybe lesson ideas for you guys. Because they have this community page where people around the world, they'll post interesting questions and other people will post their solutions and comments there. And they also have this prompt to section, which they have basic, intermediate, and also advanced topics in math and science questions. You guys can start and work on them for free today. Just sign up for the account. And if you're interested to get their annual premium subscription, which allows you to get access to all of their interesting courses, you can use the link blackpenredpen. And if you're one of the first 200 people to sign up, you will get 20% off discount for the annual premium subscription. And keep in mind, the best way for us to learn math is to practice, practice, practice. But we have to make sure that we practice the right way. So be sure you guys go check out blackpenredpen, and that's also the best way for you guys to support my channel. Thank you guys so much. As I often tell my students, continuous functions are nice because, for example, when we multiply or when we do function compositions of 2 or 3 or 4 continuous functions, the results are still continuous. But what if we do them infinitely many times? What will happen? Well, as we all know, we must be careful with infinity. So in this video, let me show you a situation that when you have to multiply infinitely many continuous functions, the result might not be continuous, so you'll see. Anyway, here we are going to start right here. I will define my first function, f1. So this is just going to be x to the first power. I will have to define a sequence of functions, right? That's my first one right here. And of course, this is just x to the first power. We can have a graph right here nicely. It's just this line. And next, I will have f2. And you guys can guess it, this is just x squared. And of course, this is just a parabola, so I will just have this right here for you guys. And let's do maybe two more. The next one is f3, so this is just x to the third power, and the switch will be in red, as always. Color consistency. Anyway, let's graph this. It's a cubic curve, so it looks like that. And let me do one more, f4 of x. And this right here is just x to the fourth power. And the graph for that is just like the fatter version of, or the wider version of the parabola, right? So it looks like this, right? And of course, it's not really like equal to zero right here. It's just like, you know, excuse my drawing. But the graph looks like that. Anyway, we are going to do this infinitely many times. And I can write a formula for you guys first. Fn, so the nth term of my sequence of functions, which is just x to the nth power. So we are multiplying by a lot of continuous function because, of course, x is continuous. But anyway, this is what we have for now. And now let's investigate some points. Let's see, when the powers are odd, you see that when x is equal to 1, okay, we get 1 to the 1 power, 1 to the 3rd power, okay, so the y value is also 1, that's okay. But if the x value is negative 1, negative 1 to the 1st power is negative 1, so it's down here, and then when x is negative 1, the y value is also negative 1. In another word, negative 1 to the nth power, if n is odd, you get negative 1, if it's even, you get positive 1. So those are the pretty much the usual thing, right? Like this. So that's pretty much the quick thing. So if you would like, I can write this down for you guys. Fn of 1, this is equal to 1 to the n. That's just equal to 1. And I'll just say this is true for all n. And n is just a positive whole number. And fn of negative 1. This right here is negative 1 to the nth power. And we have two choices. It's either 1 if n is even, and then it's negative 1 if n is odd. Right? So just some little detail on there. Anyway, this is still technically finite, but I am going to put on dot dot dot. So we are doing this infinitely many times. And this is the formal way to define infinity. You have to take the limit. So I will just say that f of x, no n. This right here, I will define that to be the limit as n goes to infinity of all that. So it's just f n of x like this. This f of x has a name. This is called a limiting function. Let me write it down. Limiting function. And we are not really talking about the limit of the function because this is technically the limit of the sequence of functions, right? And usually people just call this to be the limiting function. And let's see, what happens to f then? Well, if you guys just refer to these pictures again, or maybe this again, and once again, all this right here are just finite value n, right? So keep that in mind. Let's see. F is pretty much, you do this, right? The limit as n goes to infinity, fn is just x to the nth power. So you can just plug in infinity, that kind of thing, to here. So it's kind of like x to the infinity, that kind of thing. So I will put this down in blue because this is not, it's not like rigorous, so whatever. I will just write this down for you guys that it seems like f of x is just like x to the infinity's power, right? So just, yeah, with a quotation mark, so just not the second derivative, just, you know, quotation mark. All right, so how does f look like? Let me just put down a bigger graph right here. This is the graph for f of x. Well, what happens at negative 1? Remember, when you plug in negative 1 into here, and you actually have infinity for the power. And because you don't know if n is going to be even or odd, it's going to be jumping around. Negative 1 in a parenthesis to the nth power, it diverges. So let me just make a note right here, if you like. Here. Negative 1 to the infinity, this right here, diverges, meaning that you do not have a limit for this. So unfortunately, I will have to put down an open circle, and I'll just put it down right here for now, all right? And now let's talk about what happens when x is exactly 1. Well, fn of 1 is 1 to the nth power, 1, this one is a solid 1. And when you have a solid 1, and then raise that to the infinity's power, this right here is 1, that's okay. So when x is 1 on this function, which is at 1 to the infinity, if x is a solid 1, the y value is 1. So that's nice. All right? And what's next, though? Well, I have to put down more note on the side for you guys. Here is another, let me just put down star. We know r to the nth power, this right here, this approaches 0. If, well, I should say this approaches to 0 as n goes to infinity if r is in between of negative 1 and 1. So for example, if r is negative 7, sorry, if r is negative 0.72, take that and erase to the infinity's power, you get 0. If r is positive 0.9999, you take that and raise to the infinity's power, you get 0. So in fact, anything between of negative 1 and 1 right here, you get 0. So this is actually the solid 0. Earlier, this curve, you can see, this part is going to be approaching 0, right? And this is like jumping up and down. But for this part, from negative 1 to 0 right here, the y value will be 0 when you take the limit. And when x is exactly 1, it actually jumps to positive 1 right here for the y value. So this right here, it's actually pretty much it. This is the only situation that you can have r to the infinity power to converge. The rest diverge. So in fact, this right here, I will define it for you guys. This f of x, which is the limiting function of the limit of the sequence of the functions, it's equal to just two values. is equal to 0 if x is in between of negative 1 and 1. So I'll just write it down like this. And you get positive 1 if x is exactly 1. And what happened to the rest? As long as you have a number slightly bigger than 1, such as 1.005, and then raise that to the infinity's power, you get infinity. So in fact, you don't have this part anymore when you're talking about this limiting function situation, because you have the infinity's power right here. So you cannot really graph that anymore. And usually what we do is, okay, we just say the third situation, if you would like, this function diverges if otherwise. So I just write this down for you guys. Anything outside of this picture, the function just, you know, not good anymore. Anyway, as you can see, all of this are continuous functions. And in fact, x to the nth power is also a continuous function if n is a positive whole number and it has to be finite. But the moment if you take the limit as n goes to infinity, that limiting function, this right here, it's no longer continuous. So this right here is an example that we really have to be dealing with, that we really have to be careful when we are dealing with infinity. And thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you have any questions or comments, just leave it down below. And be sure you guys go check out blend.org. And as always, that's it.